Have you ever heard the phrase, "You have a lot of potential"? What is potential anyway? It is the possibility of developing into something more in the future. You might say that a young baseball player has the potential to develop into a professional athlete, or that these students have the potential to grow up and become scientists who make amazing contributions to the world. This newborn baby has nearly unlimited potential because her life could develop in so many ways. Everyone has potential. It exists in all of us. But that potential can't become anything without effort and hard work. If potential is the possibility of developing into something more, then what do you think the term potential energy means? Potential energy is energy that exists, but it's not doing anything yet. In other words, it is energy stored in an object, just waiting to be released. Potential energy can be stored in an object when that object is not moving. Like this piece of fruit hanging from this tree. It is full of potential gravitational energy. Although its energy is stored now, it has the potential to be used later. Let's say this piece of fruit falls from the tree. Its potential energy has been transformed into kinetic or moving energy. Gravitational energy is a common form of potential energy. Everything has potential gravitational energy if you lift it up, because gravity is working to pull it down. Consider this wrecking ball. As the operator lifts the ball higher and higher, its potential energy increases. As the ball stops moving, its potential energy reaches a peak, until the ball is released. At the moment the ball starts to move, its potential gravitational energy is converted into kinetic energy. Some objects have more potential gravitational energy than others, depending on their mass and how high above the ground they are. Which object has more potential energy? A bowling ball held up high or a tennis ball at the same height? The bowling ball is heavier and has more mass than the tennis ball, so its potential energy is greater. Can you think of any other types of potential gravitational energy? It's important to note, however, that gravity isn't the only way an object gains potential energy. Another common type is elastic potential energy. This type of energy is stored in objects that have elasticity, like a rubber band that can be stretched or a spring that can be compressed. The more an object can stretch or compress, the more potential elastic energy it has. A common example of elastic energy is a bow and arrow. An archer uses kinetic energy to pull back the bowstring until it is taut. The kinetic energy from the archer's hand is transferred into the tight bowstring. At this exact moment, the string is brimming with potential elastic energy. Once the archer releases the string, all that potential energy is converted into kinetic energy, propelling the arrow forward. Can you think of any other types of potential elastic energy? Of course, there are other types of potential energy, like potential chemical energy, potential nuclear energy, and potential magnetic energy. In fact, potential energy is all around you. It's in the food you eat. It's in the firewood you burn while camping. It's in a plant the moment before the sun shines on it. And in the candle wick right before you light it. Like a firework waiting to be set off, potential energy is stored in objects, just waiting for the perfect moment to become kinetic energy.